This day, I'm actually representing not just the design group, but also the construction group. And this day represents to all of us, in analogy of education, graduation for us. We've spent the last 8 years with this project in various capacities, and it's been a wonderful ride. It began with us meeting with Paul and his team and defining a need. And that need began with a very mixed bag of pieces. And obviously, they felt they could do more clinic spaces. There was a growing need for more operating spaces and a combined emphasis on having research be a part of their mission. As fundraising began, we added to the formula Bill and Dee Brehm and their vision for what could really happen here. And through a workshop where they brought in the McDonough Partnership, we had a wonderful two-day intense working session where we came out of it with a series of goals and aspirations. And among some of those goals that are now reflected in the building was for the building to be as efficient as possible so we could get as much as possible, a building which offered clarity to everyone who used it. And that clarity had very diverse users. We had the person who was elderly coming here for his one visit who needed to find his way easily and find his way out equally easily with probably dilated eyes. We had the person who came every day, day in and day out, to carry forth their goal of doing research. We wanted their space and their environment to be one that was positive and a space they wanted to come to every day and be an example for others and to help the University of Michigan recruit the finest and best talent. And thirdly, we wanted to make connections. We wanted a building that connected not only to the adjacent existing Kellogg Eye Center project, but connected to the community, both in Ann Arbor, but also connected to the world. And that was our challenge going forward. If you can visualize at the holiday time where you go out shopping and you bring home a series of small jewelry boxes, a large couple of shoe boxes, and maybe three or four shirt boxes, and you have to carry them all in one bag, it's often a challenge. And as designers, we were presented with that challenge. How could we fit the exam rooms, which were very small, the ORs, which were large, and the shirt boxes or the lab floors above that? And oh, by the way, the ORs had a series of things sticking up through them called very large ducts, and make it all work together in a way which, again, was efficient, offered clarity, and connected with the world. Today, as you tour the building, as you enter, you will find elevators to your right and left. The ones to your right as you enter are the patient elevators, and those only go to the first four floors that service the patient needs. And we put our highest use patient activities and also our youngest population on the first floor so they wouldn't deal with the elevators at all. As you go up through the building above that, then the left-hand elevator, which is for staff and for researchers, extends on up to their appropriate floors. And you'll find, again, there's a certain degree of color change, again, identifying the various uses in the building to help you understand your way and your clarity. Also, the building, as you go deeper into it, achieves a very efficient plan. The stairs are pulled forward, the elevators are pulled forward, so that we could create as much usable space behind that sometimes inefficient space as possible, so we could build and make as much as we possibly could. But most importantly, I think, was connection. You'll find stairwells that are glass on the corner so that people can circulate up and down them. Today, if you get a chance, I'm assuming they're open, if you get a chance and you want to have a wonderful view of the Huron Valley, go stand in the stairwell and look in either one of the stairwells. It's a tremendous view. But we wanted to encourage people to link together, to communicate, and be together. As I pointed out, we were able to connect with almost every floor in the existing Eye Center expansion, which makes, again, for connections between the two buildings and make it feel as one. And with that, we didn't try to build a building which matched the existing building, but complemented that building, because our needs and our desires were not the same as the wonderful building that was built in 1982, I think it was, by William Kessler and Associates. I think one of the most exciting things, though, about connections and connection with the community would be the cure room. That was a vision of Bill and Dee. Bill brought to us the concepts of systemization into the cure of science. We created a room called the cure room on the fifth floor. And the idea there is that we are able to link people throughout the world with today's medium so that we can all be sharing information together. And that was a challenge to all of us as we started to design this project, but it was a challenge that we thought was going to be so exciting that we just leapt at that opportunity, and it was great. So now we look forward to, as graduation day occurs, we look forward to seeing this building do great things. We look forward to reading about the wonderful things that come out of this building and knowing that we had a small part with it, but the real success now lies ahead with your staff and, Peter, your staff. Thank you very much.